So here we'll start with the SAP NetWeaver application server, ABAP architecture, and memory management, performance analysis, database access programming, data table buffering, data object buffering, and internal tables, the performance of the internal tables, and remote function calls. So these are the things that we can discuss. So we'll first describe the architecture of SAP NetWeaver, and then we'll go for the role of work process in SAP NetWeaver. Okay, basically we all know that we all know the three-tier architecture. We'll have a single-tier architecture where you have your desktop or laptop which is not connected to any of the systems. This can be considered as a one-tier architecture. Two-tier architecture in the sense we have a database and clients. Database is there and clients are there. And three-tier architecture is that we have the database tier, application tier, and presentation tier. So in the NetWeaver concept, there is additional layer that is being introduced, that is internet. So you will have a database, you will have the application server, and then you are connecting through internet, you are connecting to the application tier from the presentation tier. So in the presentation tier, you are actually maybe you making use of a portal website. Okay, so from there we are accessing it. So this is something which is in a NetWeaver architecture. And when we talk about multi-tier architecture, in multi-tier what happens is, multi-tier in the sense you will not have more than these three, but you will have multiple number of databases and multiple number of application processes, multiple number of presentation tiers. So when we started our career, like at the time, we had the database needs to be completely transformed, or you need to be replaced. The old database needs to be replaced by the new database. So for example, like let's say you have a 8 GB pen drive, okay, and can you upgrade it to 16 GB pen drive? No, right? So the same thing used to happen at the time. Database could have not been upgraded those days, older days. Like now we can just simply attach one more database to it and make it like, you know, you can have a very strong database. You can have multiple databases connected to one and they all work together as a one system. Okay, this facility was introduced in 1990s. And before that it was not there, database. Okay, now here we have application process in which we have multiple application tiers, and multiple presentation anyways was there from the beginning. So because of that, this is called multi-tier architecture, or in some softwares it is also called as n-tier architecture or multi-tier architecture. Okay, so in this we have multiple application servers, multiple application levels, and we have the central instance, and then we have the dialog instance. So we'll always have, whenever we have multiple application tiers, we'll have a central instance and we have a dialog instance. Dialog instances always follow what we're controlling from the central instance. Now here we have the NetWeaver application server ABAP. So AS stands for application server. So in this we have the host, and here we have the ABAP instances, and here we have the ABAP database. Now here in the dispatcher actually takes care of all the whatever commands that you give from the presentation tier will be actually been backend work together from the work process. So the ABAP dispatcher will actually do the functionalities. Yeah, this is about the scalability. So we have a dispatcher, we have a host, and then we have the scalability where we have multiple application servers. It's a single application server. Here we have the multiple application servers. So we have a message server and a unique NQ server in the ABAP, system central service. So this is something which is related to only ABAP. So this message server and NQ server will connect with the database and then respond back to us. Okay, so the database can be installed on a different host from the application server instance. So application server can be in a different place and database can be in different place, but they need to be connected. Okay, they are two different instances. Now here this is what we have. So we have discussed that OpenSQL statements are something which is always recommended. Now what do we mean by OpenSQL statements? Is the statement that you are writing in general are all called OpenSQL statements. Now remember, there is nothing to do with the OpenSQL language. Okay, OpenSQL language is different. From the ABAP perspective, what are OpenSQL statements? Is any statement which goes and hits the database. Now select statement hits the database, so that's the reason it's called OpenSQL statement. And read statement also hits the database. That's the reason it's called OpenSQL. So these are the things that we have. Now here we have OpenSQL. OpenSQL will go and first check the local buffers. Now what will happen is the
OpenSQL statements will first go and connect and check if the data is there in the local buffers. Okay, how do you get the data in the local buffers? You basically get the data through into the internal table, right? You write the select statement, and that select statement, what it will do, it will actually get the all the data from the database to internal table. Now that is actually saved in the local buffer, and that local buffer data is actually being interacted with the ABAP interpreter through database interface. And once it's been done, you can get the data. That is the select statement that we normally use as a OpenSQL statement. But native SQL statements, every time you give a command, it will go and hit the database and bring the data from there. So in that, you will not have loop. You will have select and select. Inside select and select, you will write the write statements. What will happen is, for every record, it will go and hit the database. If you want to extract 1,000 records, 1,000 times the system will go and hit the database, which is actually, it will kill the performance of the database, which is not preferable up to HANA database. But in HANA database, you can use native SQL statements also. I'll explain you about that why. Okay, HANA database, the performance tuning also will be completely different when it comes to HANA database. Okay, now here we have the ABAP processors, we have the dispatcher, we have, these are all the background jobs. D stands for dialogue processing, B stands for background processing, log management, update versions, spool. All these things will be taken care of by the ABAP dispatcher. ABAP dispatcher will take care of this, and it will assign the work to the database. So it will get the data from the database. So ABAP message server, gateway, and internet communication manager, these are all the things that we have that will connect to the ABAP dispatcher. For example, we have a gateway. Gateway is in a sense SAP GUI, and then we have something internet through website you are logging in, something like that. Now here we can go to SM50 transaction. This SM50 transaction is basically for checking out all the work processes which are running in your system. Okay, SM50 transaction. You can make a note of the transaction codes. SM50 is for work processes of an instance. So if you want to check how many work processes are running in your system and what they are exactly doing, you can just go through this SM50 and you can check that. This is about the all work processes of an instance. And then we have SM51. SM51 shows you all the instances of an SAP system. So if you want to see what are the instances that are running, okay, instances in the sense like whenever you are logging into systems, each login is considered as an instance. So this instance, we have to have this as we have server time, server name, information, and then we have these options. So this transaction code for all instances of an SAP system stands for SM51. Okay, now you can go to transaction code SM66 for all active processes of an SAP system. So if you want to check what are the processes that are active right now, okay, if you are running a program, that's a process, right? So how many processes are running and what is the process status of that process? You can just go and check in SM66 transaction. So you can make a note of it. SM50 transaction, SM51, and SM60. 51 will check, you can check all the instances of the system. So in the server, how many people have logged in? Those instances. So each login is considered as an instance. Now we have dialog work processes, multiplexing. So we have dialog work processes here. So we have user content, and then we have the rollout. Okay. So what is rollout and what is rolling? This is something which we need to understand. Okay. Rollout and rolling of the memory. Okay. There are two types of memories in SAP. One is the SAP memory, another is the ABAP memory. SAP memory and ABAP memory. So what will be stored in ABAP memory? What will be stored in SAP memory? Imagine that you have this, assume that you have got the data from the database table to internal table. You have got the data into internal table. Guess where it will be stored? Is it in SAP memory or ABAP memory? Internal table data. Temporarily, it has to be stored somewhere, right? You are bringing the data from the database and storing it in internal table. Temporarily, that internal table has to store somewhere, right? So where it will be stored? Whether it is in ABAP memory or SAP memory? ABAP memory.
So in that case, and now if you do some configuration or if you do an entry into some screens, that will be stored in SAP memory. So here what we do is we'll have roll out and roll in. Okay, if you enter some data into a screen, the data from one screen to another screen, it has to be passed on. Okay, let's say if you want to pass the information from one screen to another screen, then from one screen to another screen, if the data has to be passed on, it has to be through rollout and roll in. So the process of getting the data from the previous screen process after input to the next screen process after input. Okay, so to that process is called rollout and roll in. So rollout is the process of getting the data from there, and roll in is the process of getting the data again back to the next screen. So from one screen to another screen, this is how we pass on the information. Okay, so this is the instance memory. Instance memory, in the sense, it's understood that it's temporary memory. So here we have the SAP work process. So we have task handler, and we'll have the database interface, DynPro processor, ABAP processor. Then we have the database library. So we have database interface, we have the database library, disp+work.exe. Now here we have the task handler. Now this task handler, actually it comprises of this entire SAP work process, comprises of the task handler, ABAP processor, DynPro processor, and database interface. Database interface is something which will go into connect the database. Basically, this is a work process transaction updates. Now, if let's say you want to update the data somewhere, or you want to delete the data, or you want to insert the data, or you want to modify the data, for all these things, you have the database. You need to have the database access. So in this process, we'll have the transaction update. So we will have transaction updates, which I'm going to discuss. So this entire process of getting the data from one screen to another screen, or all these things, comes under the SAP transaction update. Okay. Now we'll discuss about the memory management. So we'll identify the memory areas used in SAP systems, analyzing memory allocation, defining the architecture of work process, analyzing memory consumption using the ABAP debugger, and analyzing the ABAP reports at design time. These are the things that we're going to discuss in the memory management. Task. See, task handler anedi, it is a part of the ABAP work process. It's a part of work process. Task manager, what it will do? It will perform all the tasks. Execution, we program execute. See, the program has to be run. So that will be taken care of by the task manager. Anishana.